is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
All right, welcome back from that break. And in case you're joining us right now, well, you're still watching Game On, and definitely we'll look at the very biggest stories when it comes to all of sports. But quickly, before we get to talk the English Premier League, the game's coming through later this evening. There's a couple of interesting fixtures and certainly football down in the Copa del Rey as well. There's a bit of tennis currently happening that is down in Australia. The Australian Open is currently underway. And we've already seen some big names getting knocked out, but there's also a couple of new emerging names as well. And the latest coming through is that Britain have suffered quite the big shocker, because two of their biggest names, including the ladies' British number one, Johanna Konta and Carl Edmund, both getting knocked out at the first round. Before we get to talk some of the other big names in there as well. Quickly, Faith, I'll start with you. For Team Britain, things have not kicked off on the right note.
And if you look at Konta, those are the only probably medal hopefuls they have. If you look at Dan Evans, I don't think he's a ranked player, but I don't think Great Britain was looking at him to medal in any position, because I feel like Carl Edmund a few years ago went up to the quarterfinals or semifinals, quarters at the Australian Open. Johanna Konta, what people actually don't know about Johanna is I think she was born in Australia, but she naturally at 14 she moved to Europe and then she became an English citizen. So I just feel like for every time she's in Australia, she just does not perform. I don't know, maybe because it's a mental thing, because she probably feels like she did the country in, because I think when she moved to Europe, she was probably not very talented at the time, but I think Johanna will always forever feel like Australia did not believe a lot in her.
Sharon, you know, the interesting thing is Coco Gauff, a 15-year-old, knocking out Venus Williams earlier in the week. But most of the big names are still in there. Serena Williams, you know, Caroline Wozniacki for the women as well. Petra Kvitova had a big matchup yesterday. For the men, though, Rafael Nadal and Roger Federer. The question is, whoever wins this Grand Slam could go a long way, because Federer is on 20, Nadal is on 19. Both of them have moved into the second round. How would you make of the event so far?
Well, of course, like for Rafael Nadal's case, it has been quite very hard for him. Remember that he's been the Portuguese. He has been there, and the last time he won a champion, like he won, was in 2009. Yes, if I quite remember very, very well, and of course it was against Roger Federer. So it's not something that has been so easy for him to come out, and of course, like his win against this gentleman, the Bolivia's Hugo, was a swift win, winning 6-2, 6-3. It's just something which we just came all over. And this is a gentleman who is ranked 72nd in the whole world. So basically for Nadal, if you look at the ranking of his opponent alone, was quite easy for him. And it's a drought for him for all this time round. So you'd expect that you're going to have a very good run in the nearby future to come as you still go on. But I wanted to hint on also a little bit on Konta. Konta is playing, I think, her second game in five months, because she suffered kind of a setback in injury, and the setback was quite very tough for her. And like she stated it very clearly, having that history of coming from Australia, and then you're now playing for England, there's that fever you develop. East or West, they normally say East or West is always the best.
Yeah.
And there's that natural atmosphere that comes in you that, no, how am I playing against? And, you know, she's being knocked out by a Tunisian, an African, by the way. It's something that we're not talking about.
Africa.
Yeah, I mean, all jabba is not something very easy for this African lady to come out. I think it's something that we didn't give out a very good headline. Should have been an African youngster knocks out, probably.
Yeah.
I mean, a Briton. So for me, as an African, first of all, it's something very easy, something you talk about. And then for Edmund's sides, yes, he's been a semi-finalist for quite all this long, but you know, It's a very big shock for the Britons, and they have to go back to the drawing table to see what to do.
Yeah. All right, quickly, guys, away from that, but still staying with tennis. Tell you what, the King of Clay, yes, a 19-time Grand Slam winner, one of the most successful men, that is Roger Federer, is also through into the second round, and he's going to be one of those names that everyone will be looking out for, especially as we head into the latter stages of the Australian Open. Obviously, the battle will be between him, Novak Djokovic, and certainly that is Roger Federer as well. So many people like to call them the big three in there. Mm. And there's a couple of new faces that have come through, Dominic Thiem and company. Mm. Can they battle in there?
Yeah, they could, but like as of today morning, I think Felix Auger-Aliassime was knocked out by Ernest Gulbis. You see the thing about players, like these young boys, you live off watching YouTube videos of Federer, Nadal, forgetting like the Lord Daddy, you know. Mm. I wouldn't, okay, that's the wrong word, but like, you know those players that are always on tour, they've been on tour for 20 years, but like, you don't experience his type of tennis all the time. And one thing I do know about a player like Ernest Gulbis, he's very crafty. So, as opposed to looking at, if you're looking at these young kids, like, if you're looking at kids like the Greek wonder kid.
Tsitsipas.
If you're looking at players like Tsitsipas, and you are Tsitsipas, you're only concentrating on, I'm thinking of Djokovic, Nadal, I'm quarterfinals, Zverev, those kids.
Someone will shock you along the way.
You have to, I mean, Grand Slams are so bad. You have to play five good sets each game. You go into every game thinking, okay, it's going to go
it's
five.
It's going to be a win.
As opposed to straight. And you know the worst thing is in Australia, the conditions are very difficult. Mm. During day, it's hot. It's
total,
really,
terribly
Melbourne
hot,
is not the kindest, you know, Grand Slam during day. But in the evening, it's cool and comfortable. And that's why you see the superstars would rather play in the evening, apart from, of course, Nadal, who likes the sun. And if the Australian Open final was played during day, he would definitely have had more Grand Slams in that place.
Okay.
But the fact that it happens in the evening,
in fact, talking about weather, I think Edmund has also had something to cry
he always
about.
Struggles.
Rain, you know, like there was that heavy rain that interrupted their play, and the game had to be pushed on to the next day. And actually, he made a statement. He said, "For me, I would prefer to play under clear sunshine, but you see, the weather you can't." But again, it in an African proverb, it's they say, "Only it is only the lazy farmer who blames his tool."
Okay.
So Edmund cannot blame his tool, cannot blame sunshine or rain. I mean.
All right, quickly, guys. The bushfires are out, and certainly all the focus continues to be on the first Grand Slam down in Australia. But away from that, let's talk a bit of the transfer window, because it was confirmed earlier today. The Tanzanian Bwana Samata did go and sign a 4.5-year deal with the Premier League side Aston Villa. He also becomes the first Tanzanian to play in the English Premier League as well. 10 goals he scored this season for the Belgian club side, that is KRC Genk. Sharon, he says for the people back home, it actually means a lot to him. What do you make of Bwana Samata's move?
In Kiswahili, tunasema hongera sana kabisa. Hongera wa Tanzania, hongera Afrika Mashariki, hongera Bwana Samata, kwani ni mchezaji wetu msanifu kabisa wa Afrika Mashariki. Tuko na furaha kabisa. So basically congratulations. Hongera means congratulations.
Right.
I was saying congratulations East Africa, congratulations Bwana Samata, congratulations and to him and the family, us as Ugandans and Africans, we are proud.
Yeah.
Tuko na nini kabisa. So his transfer actually makes very good statement about East African talent. But again, the question comes, do we have any Ugandan? We hope some years to come to go and play in English Premier League.
Yeah.
When I posted about this news yesterday on my my Facebook account, and guys are like, "Nice, Sharon. Do you think we even actually have anyone closer going to Europe? No, at least even only Sheffield United, against Arsenal." I say, my friend, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
But the truth of the matter is, it leaves a lot of questions. For Bwana Samata, he had to travel, first of all, from East Africa. Mm. He went to AC Vita, TP Mazembe, scoring at least more than 49 goals in 98 appearances. So it clearly tells you how terrifying this gentleman has been. And then going out to Genk and then playing against, was it in Champions League?
Against Liverpool.
Liverpool, he scored a goal.
Yep.
I think he scored a goal against Liverpool. So that is when he made his breakthrough and he made that headline, the East African star. So he joins the likes of Wanyama and others. So For us as East Africans, we are happy, but we are waiting for the performance in the pitch.
All right, there you go, guys. Quickly, before we get to go, let's have confirmation of some of the fixtures coming through in the Spanish Copa del Rey, as games do get to return later on this particular evening. Some of the top teams, including Real Madrid, certainly Atletico Madrid and Barcelona should be in action. But there you go, Real Zaragoza will take on Mallorca today. Recreativo, Helva, will be at home against Osasuna. And then Sevilla will take on Levante. So those are the three fixtures to look out for today. And also, there's a bit of football to look out for in the English Premier League. And let's have a look at some of those fixtures. Aston Villa at the Villa Park will be welcoming Watford. Bournemouth at the Vicarage Road will be up against Brighton. Southampton will head down to the Selhurst Park down in London, face off against Crystal Palace. Meanwhile, in Merseyside, Everton at the Goodson Park will be welcoming Newcastle. And then Manchester City will be heading down to the Bramall Lane to come up against the Blades of Sheffield United. And the pick of the bunch will certainly be the the London Derby, as Chelsea do get come up against Arsenal. So there you go. That is midweek football when the English Premier League does get returned. And guys, as we go, Chelsea, that is Arsenal, quickly as we wrap up.
Well, it's going to be a very tight game. I was trying to look at various analysis giving about these two teams.
Yeah.
First of all, if you look at Arsenal's quint right now, Aubameyang being out due to one more game to go due to suspension, leaves them a lot. Because even if you saw the substitution of Arsenal against Sheffield United, Lacazette, I think Arteta has learned a lesson probably. Arteta shouldn't have been substituted so quick, so much in that game. And of course, Chelsea is coming in a game where they've lost a game against Newcastle. So you expect a lot of pedigree in today's game.
All right. Thank you so much, Faith. Thank you so much, Sharon, as well. And a big thank you to everyone that has been watching out there. Many, many thanks for your company. And definitely remember, always probably powered by 1xBet. But hey, till tomorrow, I've been watching Game On, and it's certainly a wrap.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Game On is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.